Testing, testing. Can you hear me? To the airport we go.
I just quit my job and have a week before starting my next one. So what better way to use my time than by exploring some new countries? Join me on my first ever female solo trip.
I am about to board on our Scoot airline to Singapore. Yay! This is my first solo trip, so I'm a little bit nervous. And people's lining up, so I'm getting very nervous, and I'll record this later. Okay, so I found a little corner next to the escape chute because I just really don't like recording things live or in front of people. I chose Singapore and Malaysia because they are like one of the safest countries in Southeast Asia. I only booked the plane tickets last week and I didn't have time to like plan my schedule. I planned everything today, so for the next 6 days. And also, I know this is a very uncrispy microphone and it's very cheap. I got it for like $5 on Shein. Okay, I'm done ranting. Bye.
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 Elena out of Taiwan. Of Taiwan. I have arrived in Singapore. So, right now it's 3 in the morning and I cannot check in into my hotel until 3 p.m. So I have 12 hours to kill. Here's my plan. I am letting myself stay stranded until at least 11 a.m. because that's when the Jewel rain vortex thing opens. I am determined to stay until then. But as you can see earlier, I decided to do my skincare and put my contacts in because I'm just going to sleep here for a bit and just crash. Honestly, everything here is pretty new. It's really pretty. It's like, it looks like a mall. Like there's like no one here right now. So it's a very isolating experience, very quiet. So I should speak louder right now. Should I do a dance real quick? I'm done. Come with me to explore. Let's go. I actually think I found it.
This is how it looks like. It smells very humid in here. It's very pretty. For now though, I think I found my napping spot. I think it's gonna be over there. Yep. So I did find a place to snuggle. There's actually a lot of people snuggling around, like they're all hiding. We'll work with it, and I think I'll just try to catch some sleep here.
Good morning. It is 7 a.m. right now. I'm so tired. I don't know how I can last the rest of today. The night safari. Tonight at 9:15, so I need to survive. It's been 4 hours, but I basically did not get a week of sleep at all. But let me show you how my living situation is like. That's also why I'm so tired. That happens every 5 minutes, I think. I just wanted you guys to catch me in a better lighting. I think this lighting is so much better. Also, I used trip.com to purchase my airline tickets this time, so I thought I should give them a quick shout out by standing in their little booth here. I only spent $126, okay, $126, to purchase my one way from Taipei to Singapore, and then from Malaysia back to Taipei. They really came in clutch this time and got me a very good deal. I really want to go to Mount Fuji, actually. I want to climb Mount Fuji, but that will be a story for another time. I'm just trying to look more awake, okay? Okay, so this is my breakfast that I got at 10 a.m. because I'm really not that hungry, but traditional Singaporean breakfast with our toast with butter. It's very crunchy thing. Two soft-boiled eggs, and then I added soy sauce and white pepper into it, and then my Americanas. It's good. It's like when I travel, I'm too anxious to eat properly. It's currently 10:53. Everyone's lining up because the vortex will start running at 11 a.m. Everyone's minding their own business, so I'm getting a little bit more self-confident. I think it's worth staying 7 hours in the airport for, but now I'm gonna head over to my hotel and drop off my luggage, so here we go. Okay, so just dropped off my luggage at Holiday Inn Orchid Center, and then now I am going to my first destination, which is Bugis. Oh, I guess that's just the way things go. There's so much left to say. I guess I'm just a bigger guy. And there's too much on my mind that I don't even want to try. Guess it's not far from the ordinary. They do say love is blind. This is the French toast with the sardine. Wait, close up here. Close up right here. But the drink just now, it was really good. Okay, I'm done. That's just the way things go. And I don't mind that that's the way things go. And I don't mind. Oh, I guess that's just the way things go.
S. Rajaratnam left an indelible mark on Singapore's history as a founding leader and chief national ideologue. His legacy is multifaceted and enduring, touching various aspects of Singapore's development.
Deserted section. Let me get out. I am back out here in the wild. I have arrived.
all this. Okay, let's settle down. Okay, this is my room. Nice bathroom. Put my stuff here. Two double beds. And let's see what the view is gonna be. It's gonna be more buildings. Yay. Ooh.
I can use one bed to lay with my dirty clothes. And the other one with the clean bed. I love it. Okay. These shoes hasn't been off of my feet for 23 hours. So I need a break. Also, I need to check my phone.
I went to 3 meals a day. I bought my salty egg chicken with rice to go, and it's so yummy. I mean, I haven't tried it yet, but I know it's gonna be yummy because Daniel Tamago is the one who recommended it, so it will be good. And with some, I think these are shrimp chips that you're supposed to eat it with the egg. So these ones. And then it comes with this sauce. I think it's chili. Just chili sauce. Tea from Tariq. I also have my leftover breakfast that I never finished, the kaya toast. People weren't kidding when they said you have to eat it when it's like toasty and crisp. Like immediately. It doesn't taste the same. I bought the sauce though, so I can recreate this at home.
Cheers.
It's good. It would have tasted better if it was, if I ate it like immediately.
I knew it. I'm gonna add the chip in. Done deal. Like that. It's so crazy.
This is my first proper meal of the day. But today was just all like walking around like Bulgus area and then Little India. I finished day one almost. I have my next safari later. Wow, I'm actually demolishing this. I think this one specifically, I mean, I haven't tried others yet before, but I feel like I'll give this one like a 6.5 out of 10.
It will lift the foothills behind and wade through the marsh. Also notice some spotted deer. To the right, these are Asiatic lions. Unlike their African cousins, Asiatic lions have to work as a team to bring in a rhino. It can weigh. Rhino skin is, in fact, very sensitive. Spotted hyenas are big buffaloes grazing or taking a cool dip of grass. Despite their bulk, give a strange, unknown animal. And the same means warrior in the Malay language. He was born in Mira, the bull elephant we saw earlier on. Good looks.
Something such a big ivory.
Honestly, it's so scary to do a night safari by yourself with no one to be with you. I'm terrified.
Big fish owl. They're all like just hanging out over here. Imagine walking like this by yourself at night.
What are the lions mating or something? Why is it so loud?
Bathroom in the night safari. I put my glasses on because I really have night blindness and I can't see.
Right there.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So pretty.
Good morning. This is outfit of the day. I haven't put in my... Oh my God. Cleave it.
Good morning. I am off to Chinatown. Oh, I didn't bring my microphone. Let me go back. Okay, now I'm ready to go. Going to Maxwell Center in Chinatown. And then after I eat my breakfast and maybe walk around in Chinatown, I will make my way. Somebody don't think twice with. Get you somebody to speak your language. Get you somebody to pick a blank sheet.
Actually, it was the same night, but just a couple of hours before I landed, they had a typhoon.
I did not know Cafe Monochrome was the OG store, or Singapore was the OG in here. Interesting.
I want some, but I don't think I can eat this all by myself, so. Pull it back, let it fly, guess my target hits, yeah. Get you somebody to fall in love with. Get you somebody. Very detailed, like every single... gods or deities are all very detailed, but very colorful. Gardens by the Bay.
Because it's Mid-Autumn Festival, they have this section, which is so cute.
The AC is so strong in here.
I am in the cloud forest. I've been here for the past 20 minutes because first off, it was way too hot outside, and in here is only like 50, 60 degrees. So it's very cool, and I just spent a lot of time trying to take my own videos/pictures. The misting is gonna start in 15 minutes. That is why I've been here for the past like half an hour or two, because the misting is either at 12 p.m. or 2 p.m. and then another one at 4 p.m. and then there was also a 10 a.m. but I missed at 12 p.m. so I'm trying to stay tight for the 2 p.m. one. Yeah.
Getting the pineapple ice cream from McDonald's. I wanted the pineapple McFlurry, but it was way too big. The cup was way too big.
Oh, I should not have gotten this. Very basic.
I asked someone to take a picture for me. Did not look good, but it's okay. So that's why we have this. It's actually really pretty. You get the whole Marina Bay and you got your super tree right here. So it looks good. Maybe I could waste my time on you. Never mind all I want to be. So happy. If you do it just the way you like, maybe I could waste my time on you. Ferrari. Impressed that the plants can climb all the way up here. Oh my god, my knees are actually quivering.
I'm finally gotten one.
I'm gonna get the lime juice because I personally hate coconut water, but everyone's ordering this right now. What does that mean? Kind of figured why not just get out of the crowd by coming to a place where no one would want to be, which is under the bridge. I spent like the last 30 minutes, almost 40, taking pictures because I could not find the right angle and I also could not find the right people to take pictures for me. So therefore it was kind of difficult. Oh, also the F1 racetrack is like right next to me, so I kind of want to check it out before they have their first practice match tomorrow. Let's go now. I literally got a spot at the edge of the water just so I can see the Spectra live show next to the Marina Bay Sands. Okay, and then after this I gotta book it. I have to walk all the way over to Garden by the Bays, so for their light show.
The green light is pointing.
I've been walking for so long, I'm so tired. I literally walked behind the Marina Bays now. I was
on the other side earlier. I walked all the way back here. I'm so tired. Meet you guys back at the hotel. Let me chill in peace. My feet hurt so bad. I need to ice my feet. Okay, see you guys back. This is the pool. That's crazy. Oh my gosh. Let me just sit here for like 10 minutes. Oh my gosh.
Okay, maybe I'll come here tomorrow morning.
I know this is very bold for me for breakfast, but this is seafood fried rice. This is, oh my god, I will put the names of it there, forget. And coconut chutney and also tomato chutney sauce, steamed fish with barbecue sauce, another, forget the name, and then with curry, and then two melons, and a little bit of masala tea because I've never had it before, so I wasn't sure if I liked it.
I just landed in Fort Canning Park and I have my soup. I don't want it to go bad in this heat. Wow, it's really deep.
I hear a lot of people. There must be a lot of people. I anticipate maybe like 20 minutes or so, maybe even 30.
Yeah, so I just finished taking pictures. I waited almost an hour for this, and then I kind of, like, I had like a mental plan in my head of like poses I wanted to take, but the person who took it for me, see, she said I moved too fast, so she couldn't grab some of my angles. I definitely wore like the wrong outfit for it. Like, I couldn't really stretch my legs for like the poses I want.
Found a place to eat in the park.
It looks like something I can make at home, but it's okay. We'll try then.
Ooh, this broth is really, really good.
Another thing, I came on the week of F1. I didn't know about it when I purchased the airplane ticket, and I was like, why is the hotel so expensive?
There you go, Mr. Coconut.
Oh,
it's really sweet for 50%. That's good. But there's like some coconut chunks in it. It's like very small chunks for you to kind of like add more texture.
Fried banana fritters for $2.
It's raining in Singapore 30 minutes before I leave.
The timing is great.
So too much. Definitely like typhoon.
Demolished. I'm soaking wet. My umbrella broke. This is
18. Get onto the bus in the rain. It was actually so confusing. I had to ask a local because if I didn't ask, I would not have known that you needed to actually, even though you bought your tickets online, you still need to go into like their actual store and get the bus number for like to actually get on the bus. So your confirmation on your email won't not matter. You need to go and get a physical copy, like a physical ticket to get in. We'll do a small announcement of like which bus number it is, like that showed up, like because like the bus comes and goes real quick too. And then someone, the local, told me that like, let's say I'm on this bus right now and I am on AJ6, but if it's not full, they will like announce a new bus number, like maybe B54, and then they'll just like stuff people to come and sit here, apparently. And then one more thing is like for both Singapore and Malaysia, when you enter, you still need to enter like the apply for the foreign visa thing online. It's very simple. Like there's a QR code in the store, and then I'm gonna apply for it now. They also haven't checked for my passport yet, so maybe it will be coming soon. Later. Okay, it's been an hour in, basically. That was very complicated. So what happened was that we got to the border of Malaysia, and then we had to get off the bus and then like go through customs first. And then after that, and then don't forget, you have to apply for your like Malaysian like visa to get through, or else you're gonna get stuck. And then after that, you go through, and then the bus is already waiting for you, so you gotta get on. It won't wait for you, it's just gonna leave, so get on. Another maybe like 5 to 10 minutes of driving. I thought we were done. I didn't realize we had to keep going. We had to get off the bus again, this time with our luggage, and then we had to go through like actual customs again. So the first round was just like a regular like kiosk. The second one, like you're actually going through like security, and then you're like, they're scanning your bags and everything. You got to bring your like entire suitcase and luggage, all of that. The first time we only brought like just like our bags and like passports. Honestly, I had no idea this was the process, so I was so confused. So thank goodness there were locals that were like checking in on me, so God bless them. Yes.